One of the very popular questions when it comes to linked lists. You are given the head of two single linked lists and you have to find the intersection point. What does that mean? Let us say you have a list A and you have a list B. Then one of the nodes in list B points to one of the nodes in list A and hence that intersection point. Just stick with me a little longer and I will show you clearly with a diagram what does that exactly mean. Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. A place where we explore the life of technology and make programming fun and easy to learn. Today, we would be solving the problem, find the intersection of two linked lists on LeetCode. First, I will explain you the problem statement and we will see some sample test cases. Next, we will try to approach the problem using a brute force method and see what problems you may face. Going forward, we will keep on optimizing the solution and ultimately, we will also do a dry run of the code so that everything sticks in your mind. This way, you will never forget about it. So, without further ado, let's get started. Okay, so first, let us try to make sure that we are understanding the problem statement correctly. You are given the head of two single linked lists and you have to find the intersection point. Let us look at this test case that we have in front of us. Because if we understand this, we have understood the problem statement. So, if you look at these lists individually, let us look at our list 1. So, if we take head 1, then this is the current list, right? And when we take our head 2, this is a current list. So, as you can see, these are two complete linked lists in itself. By the way, if you're new to linked lists, I would highly recommend you to check out my introductory videos. So now, given this scenario, what can you see special about it? The next of node number 4 points at 16, correct? And in list 2, the next of node number 15 also points at node 16. And hence the intersection. So in this question, you need to return 16 as your intersection point, right? And there could also be a case where you are given two lists, but they do not intersect. For example, in our test case number 2, we have head 1 and this is a list in itself, correct? And we have head 2 and this is another list in itself. Note that even though it has same value 6, they do not intersect. Because in a linked list, you are concerned with the memory address. So the next of 4 is pointing at the same address as the next of 15. So basically, the address is same and hence 16 is the intersection point. Now, if this problem statement is clear to you, feel free to try it out on your own. Otherwise, let us look at some of the innovative solutions that we can solve it. A good developer always tries to come up with a brute force solution first. That is because a brute force solution can guarantee you if the solution to a problem exists. So, in this scenario, let us take up our test case once again. You have these two lists where you have head 1 that represents the first list and you have head 2 that represents the second list. Now, you need to find out the intersection point, right? And you know that the intersection point could only be determined by the addresses of the node rather than the value. So, as you can see, even though the value 4 is same in both the lists, but 4 is not the intersection point. 16 is the intersection point, right? That means you need to find out the intersection point based upon the address of these nodes. You know that these addresses could be anywhere in the CPU memory, right? So, they are pretty random. So, let me just assign some random memory addresses. So, right now, these A, B, X, Y, and Z are memory addresses for your first list, correct? And similarly, you can have some random memory addresses for your second list also. So, you can see that M, N, and O are unique addresses for your second list. But for your intersection point, you will have the same addresses, right? And as you can see, this is the intersection point. So, how does a brute force solution work? What you can do is, you can start with the first node, that is 2, correct? Or that is the memory address A. And what you can do is you can check this memory address A with all these addresses M, N, O, X, then Y, and then Z. Since it does not match with any of them, then this node is not an intersection node. Similarly, you go to your next node, and this time I am at node number 4 or address B. Now, once again, you will check this address B with the first address, with the second address of list 2, with the third address of list 2, with X, with Y, and then with Z again. It is not same anywhere, right? So this node cannot be an intersection node. Going forward, you do a next again. As soon as you do a next, you reach your next node. And this time you are at node number 16 or the address X. Now what you do? You will again compare X with the first address M, then N, then O, and then as you compare it with the next address of your second list, you encounter the address X. Now both of these addresses are same, and that means you have landed at the same node, correct? And hence you can say that 16 is your intersection node. So you found out the intersection node. But do you see the problem with this approach? You are doing so many comparisons, right? And you are doing all of these comparisons for all the nodes in list 1. What happens if your lists are very large? What happens if your intersection point is very far away? You will keep on comparing, and that will take a lot of time, right? And hence, this method is not an optimized method. So how can you optimize it? Let us start looking into that. When you try to optimize your solutions, always go stepwise. You know that you can make a space-optimized solutions and a time-optimized solutions, right? So when we were doing a brute force approach, what was your major concern? You were taking a lot of time, right, just to compare all the addresses. So how can you reduce that time? You are taking a lot of time to look up all the variables, right? You are trying to compare all the addresses. So what if you can decrease that time to look up the addresses? So let us take up our same test case once again. We have a head 1 and we have a head 2. And we have all of these memory addresses for your first list, and you have all of these memory addresses for your second list, right? Now, let us try to create a hash set that will store all of my addresses of list 1. So what you can do is you can start off from head 1, right? And as soon as you start, what is the first address you see? You see address A, correct? So you will add this address to your hash set. Next, when you do a next, you see the next node, that is B. Once again, just take this address and add it to your hash set. Then you have X, then Y, and then Z, and then ultimately null. So what you will just simply do is just add all of these addresses to your hash set. So I add X, Y, and then Z. Now this hash set is complete, and we have completed one iteration of the linked list. Next, to find the intersection point, what do you do? You start off with your head 2, that is the second linked list. And now what you can do is you can compare all of these addresses in your hash set. A hash set gives you a quick lookup time. You can do it in order of 1. So what you can simply do is you can start traversing the second list. You see this address M and you try to look it up in your hash table. This address is not found, right? So what do you do? You simply go on to your next pointer. Now try to find N in this hash set. You cannot find it. So just move ahead. Try to find O. You cannot find out O. So move ahead once again. Now you find out X. As soon as you see X, you would find this element in your hash set, right? That means this is a repeated node. And hence, you can say that the address X is the intersection node. And hence, this will be your answer. So, in a way, we were able to optimize the time taken by our solution, correct? But what just happened? In order to save some time, we are consuming some extra memory, right? We took up an extra memory of order of N. So can we try to optimize this solution even further? Sure, if you have lots of memory, then no need to worry about it. But I'm pretty sure your interviewer will ask you even further for a space-optimized solution. So what can you do about that? Let us have a look at it. Okay, since we are trying to form a very efficient solution that is both space and time optimized, let me take up an even bigger example. In this test case, you can see that we have two large lists, right? And if a solution is optimized, then the length of these lists shouldn't matter, right? As a rule of thumb, I would always say that try to visualize the problem every time that you see it. So right now, let us look at these two lists separately. If you look at list number one individually, what do you see over here? What is the length of this list? This list has a length of 10, right? And try to see the list 2 also separately. If you look at this list 2, what is the length of the list? The length of list 2 would be 6, correct? So now you know one fact, that the difference of these two lists is 4. That means you have 4 extra nodes in list 1. And after that, both the lists have the same length. So somehow, if you can reach that point, then you can find out the intersection point, right? For example, in this case, the length of list 1 is 10 and the length of list 2 is 6. The difference is 4, right? So you know that list 1 is larger by 4 elements, correct? So what happens if I take my head 1 and I advance it 4 places? So 1, 2, 3, and then 4. When you try to look at the head 1 and head 2 now, you see that just after 2 nodes, you can find out the intersection point, correct? Now, a solution that comes to my mind is take both the pointers and simultaneously move them ahead. So if I move head 1 one step and I move head 2 one step. Once again, if I move head 1 one step and I move head 2 one step, then it is guaranteed that at the intersection point, both the head 1 and head 2 will be at the same position. So when you're moving both the pointers simultaneously, there will be a point when both the pointers will point at the same node. And ultimately, this will be your intersection point. And you can simply return this as your answer. This node is your answer, right? This is the intersection node. So what do you think about this solution? We were able to fuse the beauty of mathematics and we took advantage of the difference in length and somehow we arrived at the solution, right? Now, let us try to do a dry run of the code to see how this actually works in action. On the left side of your screen, you have the actual code to implement this solution. And on the right, let us take up a sample test case once again. So you pass in the head A and head B as a parameter to the function. Next, what you do is you find out the length of both the lists. Now, I have this private function with me that will return me the lengths of both of these lists. So, as you can see, the length of list A is 5, right? So, I will write down the value 5 over here. And next, the length of list B is 3. So, this function will return a 3 to me. In our next step, what do we do is, if list A is longer, then we move the head pointer of list A. Or if list B is longer, then we move the head pointer of list B. Right now, list A is longer, right? So what I will do is, I will increment this pointer by 2 places. That is the difference, correct? So as soon as I do a head.next 2 times, what will happen is, this pointer A will move 2 steps and it will reach over here. Now, both of the pointers A and B will be at an equal distance from the intersection. And you can take advantage of this. What you simply do is, you move both the pointers simultaneously until and unless they meet. So I start a while loop until head A doesn't reach equal to head B. And what do I do in the loop? I move the head A pointer one step and I move the head B pointer one step. So that will increment A pointer over here and B pointer over here. In this special scenario, just after one iteration, we were able to reach the intersection point, right? So what you do is you simply return this as your answer. If your list was a little longer, then it would have been after a few iterations, but you would have ultimately reached the solution. The time complexity of this solution is order of n plus m, where n and m are the lengths of two lists because you are traversing them once, and the space complexity of this solution is order of 1. That is because you are not consuming any extra space. You are just traversing the lists, right? I hope I was able to simplify the problem and its solution for you. As per my final thoughts, take a moment to realize the solution that we just discussed. When you think about a linked list data structure, you don't just have the value. In a linked list, you have the value as well as the address of the node. That means that you have two parameters to play around with. And sometimes using either of these values can help you to reach an efficient solution. So whenever you encounter any such problems on linked list, first try to visualize it. Just try to plot out a diagram and see how the question is actually looking. You may be able to find out a solution that you didn't even expect. So what other solutions did you find out? What problems did you face? Tell me everything in the comment section below and I would love to discuss all of them with you. You would be also glad to know that a text-based explanation to this content is available on the website studyalgorithms.com, a pretty handy website to help you out with your programming needs. I am including a link in the description below in case you want to check it out. As a reminder, if you found this video helpful, please do consider subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends. This motivates me to make more and more such videos where I can simplify programming for you. Also, let me know what problem do you want me to solve next. Until then, see ya.